Hi, my dear students. I hope you remember what we have discussed in our classes in college. We define what we mean by a function. Function from two sets, that is, a function from set A into set B. Then we started saying function from set of real numbers into set of real numbers. So throughout our session, I already told you that a function means it's a function from set of real numbers into set of real numbers. We also studied limit of the function. Right hand limit of the function, left hand limit of the function. Hope you all remember these. Okay, keeping it in our mind, we will go on to the next section. That means, how do we compute the limit of a given set of functions and what are the laws of limit? First law is limit of a constant function, f of x equal to c. If p is any real number, the law says that limit x tends to a, f of x is equal to limit x tends to a, p is equal to c. So you can graphically, you can see the description, the y equal to c, that is our constant function, which moves in parallel with x axis. To take any value of x, the image will be y equal to c. So we get a graphical description that takes y equal to c. Next, is some examples are there. Limit x tends to 5 is 5. Limit x tends to minus 1, 3 is 3. Limit x tends to 0, 2, 5 is equal to 2, 5. What do you mean by that? First example, our constant function is f of x is equal to 5. There are second function. It's a constant function which is equal to value 3. And there is f of x is equal to 2, 5 for a range x in R. Law, next law. Law, this is the limit of the identity function f of x equal to x. What is the identity function? It is f is a function from set of real numbers into real numbers. F is said to be an identity function with f of x equal to x for every x in R. Okay, so the theorem says that if x tends to a, f of x equal to, if x tends to a, x equal to a. So graphically representing, you will get a straight. Example is, if x tends to 4, x equal to 4, if I take f of x equal to x, the image is f of x equal to x. Second one is, if x tends to 0, x is equal to 0, if x tends to minus 5, f of x equal to, if x tends to minus 5, x equal to minus 5. So we will discuss some laws of limit. For that, we first of all assume that we have two functions from f and g from R to R. If limit x tends to a f of x equal to l and limit x tends to a g of x equal to m, then we have the following law. First one is the formula. Limit x tends to a f of x plus or minus g of x equal to l plus or minus m. So remember that f of x plus or minus g of x is in the square bracket. Limit is not only for f of x, but limit is for f of x plus or minus g of x. I forgot to put that bracket. Please remember that. Second one is the first law, which says that limit x tends to a f of x into g of x is equal to l into m. This law is constant multiple law. That is, limit x tends to a c into f of x is equal to c into limit x tends to a f of x that is equal to c into l for f of x is c, where c is a constant. Now, quotient law. You know, a little bit more, it should be a little more quotient. Aware of this thing, limit x tends to f of x by g of x is equal to l by m, provided m should not be equal to 0. You remember that m should not be equal to 0. Once m is equal to 0, then the quotient law fails. Next is the root law. What is the root law? If limit x tends to f of x is equal to l, then m to the power of f of x. We can find the limit also. Limit x tends to m to the power of f of x is m to the power of l. Only condition is that n is a positive integer and n is greater than 0 if n is even. So n is even, then n should be greater than 0. And we have said that we have already remarked, because already we have studied sample law and part law, we can generalize that into any number of finite number of functions. That is, if x tends to a f1 of x is equal to n, x tends to a f2 of x is equal to n, etc., x tends to a fn of x is equal to n, then we have the following. Limit x tends to a f1 of x plus f2 of x plus x plus fn of x is nothing but then in l1 plus l2 plus x plus ln. Similarly, limit x tends to a f of x into f2 of x into etc. In the fn of x is equal to L1 into L2 into L1. We need this for the next one. We have some remarks with that. If we take f of x equals f2 of x equals etc. equals fn of x equals f of x, then the equation 1, but now this one, equation 1 gives the following result. If I need the positive integer and limit x tends to f of x equals the L, then limit x tends to f of x always to L equal to L raised to N. What do you mean by that? You multiply f n times, you will get f of x always to N. Then the limit will be nothing but L multiplied by n times. That is L raised to N. Similarly, if we take f of x to be equal to n, then equation 1 and log 8 gives the following result. What is that? Limit x tends to a x raised to n is equal to a raised to n, where a is a positive integer. We have some examples there. It says that we wanted to find limit x tends to 2 to x cubed minus 4 square plus 3. Remember that 2 x cubed minus 4 square plus 3 is in square bracket. I forgot to put that. Please put square bracket between put 2 x cubed minus 4 square plus 3 in square bracket. That is equal to, by using the sum law, we can write that limit x tends to 2 x cubed minus limit x tends to 4 square plus limit x tends to 3. That is equal to 2 into limit x tends to 2 x cubed minus 4 into limit x tends to 2 square plus limit x tends to 3. That is nothing but 2 into 2 cubed minus 4 into 2 square plus 3. That is nothing but 3. Limit of polynomial function. I hope you we have discussed what you mean by a polynomial function. A polynomial function is an expression of the form p of x equal to a n x raised to n plus a n minus 1 x raised to n minus 1 plus etc. plus a1 x plus a0, where a n minus 1, a1, a0 are a number, x is a number. This expression, a n x raised to n plus a n minus 1 x raised to n minus 1 plus etc. plus a1 x. Plus a0 is called a polynomial function. Then, if p of x is such a polynomial function, then limit x tends to a, p of x is nothing but p of a. We can prove this using the sum law and constant multiple law by repeated application. Limit p of x is equal to limit x tends to a, again that a n x is n plus a n minus 1 x is n plus etc. a1 x plus a0, that should be in the bracket first. We use the sum law, we get a multiple group together, we can write a n that is equal to a n into limit x tends to a, x tends to a, x tends to n, plus a n minus 1 limit x tends to a, x tends to n minus 1, plus etc. plus limit x tends to a 0. Using the law 1, 2, and 9, we get limit x tends to a, p of x is equal to a n x tends to n, plus a n minus 1 x tends to n minus 1, plus etc. plus a 0. That is nothing but our p a. Now we will discuss about limits of rational functions. What is a rational function? A function f is said to be a rational function. If f of x should be equal to p of x divided by q of x, where p of x and q of x are polynomial functions, and q of x should not be 0. Take note that q of x should not be equal to 0. In this case, limit x tends to a f of x is nothing but f of a equal to p of a by q of a. By applying law 2 and using the quotient, we can prove the limit of rational function. Here you know, if the numerator does not apply to 0, and denominator does apply to 0, then the limit of the quotient function does not exist. Remember that if p of x never approaches to 0, whereas q of a equal to 0, then limit x tends to a f of x equal limit x tends to a p of x by q of x does not exist. Now suppose that a function f, which takes the value f of a at x equal to a. You remember that for the existence of limit, it is not necessary that the function should attain the value at x equal to a, and that too f of a. So a function is said to be continuous if the limit can be found by evaluating at that function at x equal to a. Now, we have some trigonometric functions. We will discuss this trigonometric function. Say if a be any number in the domain of the given trigonometric function, then limit x tends to a sin x equal to sin a, limit x tends to a cos x equal to cos a, limit x tends to a tan x equal to tan a, limit x tends to a cot x equal to cot a, limit x tends to a sec x equal to sec a, and limit x tends to a cosec x equal to cosec a. Now remember that we have studied almost 11 laws of limit and some notes. But suppose that you are given a function x square sine 1 by x, and you ask to find the limit of that function as x tends to 0, none of the above laws helps us to find the limit of x square sine 1 by x as x tends to 0. So in such cases, we apply quick theorem. For that, we first discuss what do you mean by quick theorem. The truth theorem is that if f of x is less than or equal to g of x, less than or equal to x of x, for all x in an open interval containing a, except possibly at a, and limit extends to f of x is equal to n, equal to limit extends to h of x, then limit extends to a, g of x equal to l. What do you mean by that? So g of x is in between two functions, f of x and g of x, and f of x and g of x attains the same limit when x approaches to a, then limit extends to a, g of x will also take the same value l. You see that graphically. Now we will consider what happens if the limit extends to 0. So if it extends to a, it's written there, but it is not extends to a, but it is extends to 0. So we will find what is the value of limit extends to 0, x square sine 1 by x. We know that for any real number c, the value of sine changes from minus 1 to 1. That is minus 1 less than or equal to sine t less than or equal to 1 for every real number. So we have for every x not equal to 0, we have minus 1 less than or equal to sine 1 by x less than or equal to 1. So for all x not equal to 0, multiplying 2 out by x square, we will get it is minus x square less than or equal to x square sine 1 by x less than or equal to x square. Now if I choose f of x to be minus x square, g of x to be x square sine 1 by x, and h of x to be x square, we have f of x less than or equal to g of x less than or equal to x of x. Now since limit extends to f of x is limit extends to a minus x square, that is equal to 0, and limit extends to h of x is equal to limit extends to 0 x square, if that is also equal to 0, we can apply the Q theorem to show that limit extends to 0, g of x equal to 0, that is limit extends to 0, x square sine 1 by x is 0. This is the graphical representation. You see that the upper curve is y equal to x square, below curve is y equal to minus x square. So it pushes the sine 1 by x 0 as x approaches to 0. So we want to find the limit extends to 0 sine x by x. Okay, so that is consider the triangle ABD. From that C, you have a perpendicular to B. Then you know that perpendicular distance from C to AB is sine x, BD is tan x, the distance AB is 1, the angle CAB is x. Okay, now suppose that 0 less than x less than pi by 2. From the figure just above, you see we have the following condition. Area of triangle ABC is nothing but half base in pi, that is half 1 into sine x, that is half sine x, whereas the area of the sector ABC is half r square theta, that is 1 by 2 into x, whereas triangle area of the triangle ABD is half 1 into tan x, that is 1 by 2 tan x. Now you can see that from the figure, you can see area of the triangle ABC is less than area of the sector ABC, which is less than area of the triangle ABD. Okay, so as all the areas is greater than 0, so we have 0 is less than area of the triangle ABC, less than area of the sector ABC, less than area of the triangle ABD. That is, we have 0 less than 1 by 2 sine x, less than 1 by 2 x, less than 1 by 2 tan x. Okay, in the throughout the interval 0 less than x less than pi by 2, we have sine x is greater than 0, the cos x is also greater than 0. That is, the value of sine x is greater than 0, the value of cos x is greater than 0. So, multiplying the equation number 2 throughout by 2 by sine x, we will get that equation. That is, cos x is less than sine x by x less than 1. That is the equation number 3. Now, if minus pi by 2 less than x less than 0, then we have u less than minus x less than pi by 2. And equal to 3, equal to 3 becomes cos minus x less than sin minus x by minus x, it is less than 1. That is cos x less than sin x by x less than 1, which is same as our inequality 3. Therefore, both these inequalities together, we get that whenever x lies between minus pi by 2 and 0 and 0 and pi by 2, the inequality cos x less than sin x by x less than 1 always holds. Now, again, we use the Pearson's theorem here. We assume that f of x to be cos x, g of x to be sin x by x, and h of x to be equal to 1. And limit x tends to 0, f of x is limit x tends to 0, cos x, that is equal to 1. Limit x tends to 0, h of x is limit x tends to 0, 1 equal to 1. Therefore, Pearson's theorem says that if f of a and b, we have f of x is less than or equal to g of x, less than or equal to h of x, and limit f of x and limit h of x as x tends to 0 reach the same limit, then limit g of x as x tends to 0 should also reach the same limit. That is, limit x tends to 0, g of x is 1. That is, limit x tends to 0, sin x by x is equal to 1. We conclude this session by saying, by finding what is the limit x tends to 0, cos x minus 1 by x. Now, we know that sin square theta is equal to 1 by 1 minus cos 2 theta. By choosing 2 theta equal to x, we have 1 minus cos x equal to 2 sin square x by 2. Then limit x tends to 0, cos x minus 1 by x equal to limit x tends to 0, minus 2 sin square x by 2 by x. That is, limit x tends to 0, minus sin x by 2 into sin x by 2 by x by 2. That is, minus of limit x tends to 0, sin x by 2 into sin x by 2 by sin x by 2. Now we use the first rule. Limit x tends to 0 sin x by 2 into limit x tends to 0 sin x by 2 by x by 2. So limit x tends to 0 sin x by 2 is 0 into limit x tends to 0 sin x by 2 by x by 2, that is 1. That is, so that is 0 into 1, that is 0. Therefore, limit x tends to 0 cos x minus 1 divided by x is 0. I hope you have followed all these kind of things. If you have any doubt, do call me or do WhatsApp me, or maybe you can put that doubt in the comment section. There are some practices are missing, as I have told you. Maybe I will come again with another video on the next topic. All the topics are in from our subscribe set of 2K. This book is as well.